What does it mean for the college football playoff? Now, obviously, we talked about the Rose Bowl to start things off, but the USC and UCLA move to the Big Ten, I think, again, effectively squashes the alliance, and I think that it could kill that Rose Bowl partnership between the Big Ten and the Pac-12. Because these two conferences were in agreement on a lot of things, etc., and the whole time, I say the whole time, that's obviously misspeaking. USC and UCLA, as soon as they decided that they wanted out of the Pac-12, they reached out to the Big Ten. They did it because they knew they could get the most money from there, and there was actually room there, and they align academically more with those schools than they do with the SEC, et cetera, right? With these two, I don't think you're going to have that same contract in the Rose Bowl, and I don't think that the matchups are going to be as nice as they had hoped to be. The Rose Bowl always wants USC and Ohio State. That's what they want. They haven't gotten it in a very long time, but now that there's no option for that, I mean, you're going to get USC and Ohio State much more regularly by those two joining in the same conference. So what is the Rose Bowl going to do? Now, that's just one aspect of this. The other side of this, don't you think the Pac-12 and the ACC are kicking themselves for not agreeing to that playoff expansion that was talked about last year? Like, this was something that was done up, and the big hang-up from a lot of people was, one from the ACC, the Pac-12, and the Big Ten, was they wanted autonomy for the five major conferences. They got to be kicking themselves right now, because I don't know that there's any way that those two conferences, the Big 12 and the Pac-12, with the way that they are currently constructed, I don't know how they get into a four-team playoff. So on top of that, I mean, you gotta figure out, like, the big hang-up for them was the autonomy aspect of it, because the way that it was drawn up, the way it was constructed, is the top six conference champions get in. If you were going to get in, if you were going to be a conference champion in those leagues, you were going to be ranked in the top six anyway of those conferences. Like, well, I don't understand why you had the hang up on that. Now, obviously, there was a lot more going on with that. The ACC commissioner, Jim Phillips, discussed ad nauseum how much he wanted all these different things in the sport to settle down before they decided on a playoff. Well, it does not appear to be settling down anytime soon. You had an opportunity to go on and lock this thing in and make sure that you got paid, because now we'll move on to this next step of this. Do the SEC and the Big Ten even need these other conferences? Like, and yes, obviously, it's better for the sport when you have all areas of the country, all different fan bases, etc., excited about your product, right? But if you still can't get an agreement on the way that the playoff is supposed to be done, what's to stop? And the two major networks that are involved in this, obviously, are ESPN and Fox. Those are the two that really want to be involved with the playoff. What's to stop those two, Fox and ESPN, from getting the SEC and the Big Ten to come together, make an eight-team playoff, just do away with conference championship games, and then you've got an eight-team playoff for whatever kind of championship it would be, national championship, the network championship, whatever it is, right? You would have a lot more big-time matchups. You would get more Alabama, Ohio State, Florida, Michigan, Georgia, Penn State, stuff like that. That would be insane for viewership, especially in a playoff setting, right? I worry that that's the direction that this could be going. That's what I'm worried about. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.